Dear friends, English literature, romantic poetry, S.T. Coleridge, selected poems, the rhyme of the ancient manner, brief questions with answers. Brief questions 50 to 94. Question 50. How was the skin of the woman on the spectre-ship? What does it suggest? Answer. The skin of the woman on the spectre-ship was as white as leprosy, which suggests death. Question 51. Who is given the name life and death? What is the significance of this name? Answer. The woman on the spectre-ship is given the name life and death. Her red lips suggest life, while her white skin suggests death. So she is called life and death, which means lingering of death. Question 52. And the twain were casting dice. Who are the twain? Why were they casting dice? Answer. The twain were dead and life and death, two figures on the spectre-ship. They were casting or playing dice to win the ancient mariner. Question 53. Who wins the play at dice? Answer. Life and death wins the play at dice, so she gets the ancient mariner. Question 54. Fear at my heart, as at cup my lifeblood seemed to seep. What figures of speech are used here? Answer. The figures of speech used here are simile and personification. Here, fear is personified as a monster who takes the mariner's lifeblood in a cup and drinks it. Question 55. How did the 200 sailors die? Answer. The 200 sailors died one after another without sighing or groaning. Question 56. What did the 200 sailors do while dying? And so while dying, the 200 sailors cursed the ancient mariner with their eyes. Question 57. I fear the ancient mariner. Who fears the ancient mariner and why? Answer. The wedding guest fears the ancient mariner because of his skinny hand, lean and thin figure, and glittering eye. For all this, the wedding guest thinks him to be a ghost. Question 58. Alone, alone, all alone. Who is alone and why? Answer. The ancient mariner is alone on the wide sea because all his companions were dead. Question 59. I looked upon the rotting sea. Why does the ancient mariner think the sea as the rotting sea? Answer. The sea seems to the ancient mariner rotting because of its foul water, which cannot be drunk, and the sea creatures, which seemed to him ugly and hateful. Question 60. I looked upon the rotting deck. Why does the ancient mariner think the deck rotting? Answer. The ancient mariner thinks the deck of his ship rotting because it was made ugly by the dead bodies of his 200 companions. Question 61. I looked to heaven and tried to pray. Why couldn't the ancient mariner pray? Answer. The ancient mariner looked towards the sky and tried to pray to God, but before he could pray, a wicked whisper influenced his heart and made him absolutely incapable of praying to God. Question 62. How terrible is the curse in a dead man's eye? Answer. The curse in a dead man's eye is more terrible than the curse of an orphan, which can bring an angel from heaven to hell. Question 63. 7 days, 7 nights I saw that curse, and yet I could not die. What is reflected in these lines? Why couldn't the ancient mariner die? Answer. These lines reflect the agony and despair of the ancient mariner. He could not die because he had been won by life and death in the game of dice. Question 64. Her beams be mocked the sultry main. How did the moonlight seem to be mocking the sultry sea? Answer. The moonlight was cool while the sea was very hot. Thus, the cool moonlight seemed to be mocking the sultry sea. Question 65. Where did the ancient mariner saw the water snakes? Answer. The ancient mariner saw the water snakes beyond the shadow of his ship. Question 66. What were the colors of the water snakes? Answer. The colors of the water snakes were blue, shining green, and black like velvet. Question 67. How did the ancient mariner bless the water snakes? Answer. The ancient mariner blessed the water snakes unconsciously. Question 68. Why had the ancient mariner been able to bless the water snakes? Answer. The ancient mariner had been able to bless the water snakes because his guardian angel had taken pity on him as he appreciated the colors of the water snakes. Question 69. Why did the dead albatross fall off from the ancient mariner's neck? Answer. As the ancient mariner blessed the water snakes, he enjoys the grace of God, and as a result, the dead albatross fell off from his neck into the sea. Question 70. She sent the general sleep from heaven. Who sent the general sleep and for whom and when? Answer. The Virgin Mary, Mother of Jesus Christ, sent the gentle sleep from heaven for the ancient mariner when the ancient mariner blessed the water snakes from his heart. The dead albatross fell from his neck, and the Virgin Mary sent sleep from him. And the Virgin Mary sent sleep for him. Question 71. When did the ancient mariner fall into deep sleep? Answer. When the ancient mariner had shown true love to the water snakes, he relieved of the curse of the sailors and fell into a deep sleep. Question 72. How did the ancient mariner feel when he woke up? Answer. When the ancient mariner woke up, he felt that his lips were moistened, his throat was cold, and his clothes were wet with rain. Question 73. I thought that I had died in sleep and was blessed ghost. Why did the ancient mariner think that he was a blessed ghost? Answer. The ancient mariner felt his body to be so light that he seemed no more a mortal tormented by the curse, but a blessed ghost, that is, a spirit of other world. Question 74. They groaned, they stirred, they all uprose. Who are they? Answer. They are the dead companions of the ancient mariner. They groaned, moved, and stood up as if they came back to life. Question 75. Nor speak nor moved their eyes. Why couldn't they speak or move their eyes? Answer. They could not speak of or move their eyes because they had not actually come back to life. Only their bodies had been inspired by blessed spirits. Question 76. How did the dead man become able to groan, move, and stand up? Answer. The dead man became able to groan, move, and stand up, being inspired by a troop of blessed spirits. Question 77. How was it proved that the dead bodies were inspired by a troop of blessed spirits? Answer. It was proved by the fact that when the day broke, they stopped working, clustered around the mast, and sang hymns in praise of God. Question 78. What were the two voices heard in the air by the ancient mariner? Answer. The two voices heard in the air by the ancient mariner are the spirit of justice and the spirit of mercy. Question 79. What did the first voice, the spirit of justice, ask the second voice, the spirit of mercy, at first? What was the reply of the second voice? Answer. At first, the first voice asked if this is the man, the ancient mariner, who had killed the innocent albatross, and the second voice replied that he has been punished enough. Question 80. What makes the ship drive on so fast? What was the reply of the second voice to this question? Answer. The second voice replied that when the air is cut away from before the ship vacuum is created, and consequently the ship is drawn forward by the vacuum as the air behind it simultaneously pressed the ship. Question 81. What was the reply of the second voice when the first voice asked what the ocean was doing? Answer. The second voice replied that there was no wind on the ocean. It was as quiet as the slave in the presence of his master. It was busy absorbing the light of the moon. Question 82. What is meant by a charnel dungeon? Answer. A charnel dungeon is an underground room in which the bones of the dead are kept. Question 83. What was a heavenly sight? What heavenly sight had the ancient mariner seen? answer. When the ship of the ancient mariner is near the shore after his long suffering, he saw that each of the angels waved his hand as a signal to the shore. It was the heavenly sight that the ancient mariner had seen. Question 84. I saw a third. Who was the third man the ancient mariner saw? Answer. The third man was the good hermit in the skiff boat. Question 85. Why does the skiff boat approach? Answer. The skiff boat approached to bring the ship of the ancient mariner into harbor. Question 86. Where does the hermit live in? Answer. He lives in the wood that sloped towards the sea. Question 87. What did the hermit do? Answer. The hermit wrote divine hymns and sang them aloud in the woods. Question 88. How many times does the hermit say his prayer a day? Answer. The hermit said his prayer 3 times a day, in the morning, at noon, and in the evening. Question 89. What served as the cushion of the hermit? Answer. A oak stump covered with moss covered as his cushion. Question 90. How did the ship of the ancient mariner sink? Answer. When the skiff boat came within the reach of the ship, thunder-like sound was produced. Gradually, it became louder and the water was divided into 2 parts and the ship sank into it like a lump of lead. Question 91. How was the ancient mariner saved from being drowned? Answer. The ancient mariner was saved in the pilot's boat. Question 92. What request did the ancient mariner make to the hermit? Answer. The ancient mariner requested the hermit to hear him make his confession and to shrieve him. Question 93. Why did the hermit cross the mariner's brow? Answer. The hermit made the sign of a cross on his forehead, as all Christians do when they are in fear and want to avert some evil influence. Question 94. What is the moral lesson of the rhyme of the ancient mariner? Answer. The moral of the poem is that the best form of worship is to love all the creations of God without making any distinction. Thank you, friends, for watching my video.